Yeah, you know, the day you get married, it's one most never forget. But for five refugee couples from Rohingya, today carried extra emotion because it was a moment they were told would never happen. In their homeland, Rohingyans are persecuted. They are driven from their homes. They're basically denied citizenship and the right to marry. Arm in arm, the Burmese couple made their way through the courthouse this afternoon. They've only been in the U.S. for weeks, but already experiencing freedoms they've never known.
To understand their struggles, but most important, to understand their determination, their eagerness, their wanting to be here, and they're very, very grateful.
For years, they've been on the move through different countries and countless refugee camps, all in hopes of being in this place today. Ajida and Mohammed Hakim have four young children together, but until this afternoon, never allowed to legally marry.
We are happy here, and we are safe here, and everything is perfect here. So that's why we are very thankful.
Mohammed and Ajida.
For them, the certificate of marriage is not only a symbol of their commitment, but a paper representing the adversity they overcame to see this day.
By the power vested in me, by the Constitution and the statutes of the state of Illinois, I now pronounce you husband and wife. May your lives be long, happy, and with all the best wishes, I congratulate you and wish you good luck.
And Refugee One, they have helped resettle more than 500 refugees from Rohingya just in the last 6 years. But new immigration laws, they've resulted in smaller and smaller numbers of refugees who make it to the U.S., making the experience of these freedoms that the five couples experienced here today diminish day by day. From the Skokie Courthouse, Erin Ivory, WGN News.